Urothelial tumors represent a group of tumors differentiating towards the transitional epithelium. They can be found at any site of the urinary system that is normally covered by urothelium, from renal calyces to the urethra, with the urinary bladder being the most common localization of these neoplasms. Exceptionally, some other tumors in different localizations may show urothelial differentiation, for example, Brenner tumor of the ovary. Urothelial carcinoma is a common lesion. In the urinary bladder, it represents the 7th most frequent cancer worldwide. The incidence is higher in men than women, and the majority of the patients is in the 7th decade of the life. The most important risk factor is cigarette smoking. There are two major distinctive pathways by which precursor urothelial lesions progress to the invasive urothelial carcinoma. The common precursor of approximately 80% of the invasive carcinomas is a papillary urothelial hyperplasia. The papillary hyperplasia progresses to low-grade and high-grade non-invasive papillary carcinomas. Low-grade tumors frequently recur, but the risk of invasive growth is below 10%. In contrast, the high-grade urothelial carcinomas are more aggressive, with higher risk of invasive growth. Second, less common but more severe from the clinical point of the view, is a non-papillary pathway. Histologically, it takes a form of so-called flat epithelial dysplasia. It's usually referred to as a urothelial carcinoma in situ, since it's diagnosed in this stage in the most of the cases. But in rare instances, lower grades of flat dysplasia may be seen. Urothelial carcinoma in situ is a high-grade lesion with fast progression to invasive cancer in more than 70% of the cases. In the last years, a third pathway has been discussed. It's called hyperplasia-dysplasia pathway, combining both of the aforementioned changes. Now, let's discuss the microscopic appearance. First, we need to stress out that both low-grade and high-grade papillary carcinomas, despite they are called carcinomas, are non-invasive in situ lesions. On the picture, you can see low-grade papillary carcinoma with no signs of the invasive growth. A border between epithelium and stroma is smooth, and the basement membrane is intact. This type of the urothelial carcinoma is formed by papillae, covered by several layers of urothelial cells. In the past, the number of the cellular layers used to be a diagnostic criterion for distinguishing urothelial carcinoma from benign urothelial lesions. But this criterion is not valid anymore, and nowadays we recognize urothelial carcinoma according to the presence of cytological and architectonical atypia. In case of low-grade carcinoma, the cells show mild cytological atypia, certain variation in the shapes and sizes, and scarce mitotic activity. But the polarity of the cells and the maturation of the epithelium towards its surface is still preserved, although a little bit diminished. On the picture, you can even appreciate some umbrella cells. On the other hand, the overall architecture of the high-grade papillary urothelial carcinoma is less organized. Basement membrane is still intact. High-grade papillary urothelial carcinoma embeds marked cellular atypia, large hyperchromatic nuclei, numerous mitoses, including the atypical ones, and the cells show loss of polarity. Let's proceed to the flat, non-papillary pathway. The urothelial carcinoma in situ, much like any other carcinoma in situ, is defined by the presence of markedly atypical, cytologically malignant cells affecting the whole thickness of the epithelium, with no evidence of invasive growth. In contrast to the papillary pathway, no papillae formation should be seen. Invasive urothelial carcinoma is defined by the invasive growth in the subepithelial stroma, and as stated before, may progress from the papillary or flat pathway. Invasive carcinomas arising in the settings of the flat carcinoma in situ are always high-grade. Carcinomas following the papillary pathway may be both low-grade and high-grade, though a low-grade invasive carcinoma is a rare diagnosis. When the invasion into the muscularis propri is present, all carcinomas are considered to be high-grade. On the microscopic level, the invasive urothelial carcinoma forms irregular nests, strands, lobules, or grows in a solid fashion. The neoplastic cells are atypical, usually middle-sized, of various shapes and with eosinophilic cytoplasm. In summary, the tumor is histologically very variable, and sometimes other diagnostic methods that will prove the urothelial origin of the cells are necessary, for example, immunohistochemistry. This is especially true for metastatic lesions. The tumor may also show a differentiation towards other cell types and create structures of adenocarcinoma or squamous cell carcinoma, which may modify both the microscopic picture and the prognosis of the lesion.